Hi everyone, in this video I would like to explain about the bomb calorimeter, which is used to determine the calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel. Calorific value is one of the important characteristics of a good of a chemical fuel. It is determined by using a bomb calorimeter. If the fuel is in gaseous form, we use Boyle's calorimeter. That way, I don't discuss that in this video. The principle we are using in this bomb calorimeter to determine the calorific value of a solid or a liquid chemical fuel is, what we do here is, known mass of an organic fuel, maybe solid or liquid, is completely burnt in the presence of excess of oxygen in a closed vessel, airtight vessel, and whatever the heat liberated which is inside, it is made to transfer to water which is outside, which is of known quantity. When heat is transferred to water, definitely the temperature increases. Okay, by measuring the rise in temperature of water and knowing the specific heat value, that is 587 calories per gram per degree centigrade, and the calorific value of the given chemical fuel can be estimated. Okay, this is the principle we are using. Let us look at the bomb calorimeter that we are using in this experiment. So this is the typical diagram of the bomb calorimeter that we are using for this experiment. Okay, this consists of a stainless steel bomb. This is made up of stainless steel bomb, which can withstand very high pressure, and this is having a airtight cap, and it is having a stainless steel crucible. This is to place the weight sample will be kept here, and this is connected. This is having two electrical contacts where we can produce a spark. This is the spark produced by using a battery, 6 volts battery, and we have to maintain oxygen inside. So therefore we maintain oxygen at high pressure through this inlet. This is airtight inlet, and inside we have the sample, weight sample, oxygen gas with high pressure, and electric wire to produce a spark. This is generally we use magnesium fused wire which can produce a spark. And this setup, the complete setup with airtight, is immersed in another container, that is copper calorimeter. Okay, this copper calorimeter containing previously weighed water. This is the water of known quantity, and to measure the temperature, we have placed a Beckman thermometer here. So this is a highly sensitive thermometer, which can measure even the increase in 0.01 degree centigrade can be measured accurately. And to distribute the uniform heat uniform throughout the water, we have electrically operated stirrer. Okay, this is the stirrer which distributes the heat uniformly inside the water. Okay, and to prevent the entry of heat from outside, okay, this water, the copper calorimeter is again covered with this is the air jacket, this is empty space, and it is again covered with another water jacket so that the heat will not enter from outside. So this is completely airtight. Okay, this is the bomb calorimeter setup we use for the determination of calorific value. Let us look at the procedure that we follow in this experiment. But first step is the weighing the sample. We weigh the sample and we put it inside crucible. The given organic fuel is weighed accurately and transferred to stainless steel crucible of the bomb calorimeter. Then the stainless steel bomb calorimeter containing this fuel is immersed in a copper calorimeter containing known quantity of water, which is further surrounded by air and water jacket, as I told you, to which prevents the entry of heat from outside. And we maintain sufficient amount of oxygen inside to make sure that the combustion takes place completely. Initially, the temperature of water is noted down, that is taken as T1 degree centigrade. Then we produce a spark inside the bomb calorimeter. Then the fuel undergoes combustion in the presence of oxygen, and it produces a lot of heat, and that heat liberated is absorbed by water, which is around the stainless steel bomb. And as a result of that, the temperature increases, the temperature of water increases, and that temperature is noted as T2 degrees centigrade. The final maximum temperature is noted that as T2. The difference in T1 and initial and final temperature is equal to the rise in temperature. The calorific value is directly proportional to this rise in temperature. So more the rise in temperature of water, more heat is liberated. And the the heat is not only absorbed by water, we can also expect some amount of heat absorbed by other than water. For example, we have other parts, electrical contacts, copper calorimeter, stainless steel bomb. That also absorbs certain amount of heat energy, but that energy is relatively less as compared to the heat absorbed by water. That cannot be measured actually. Whatever the heat absorbed by other than water cannot be measured easily. So therefore, what we do here is to determine that, that we call it as water equivalent of calorimeter, which accounts for the heat absorbed by other than water, other parts. This can be measured by using a standard hydrocarbon fuel of known gross calorific value that I'll discuss later in the next slide. So by measuring the rise in temperature of water, of known quantity of water, and knowing the specific heat of water, knowing the weight of a chemical fuel and the water equivalent of calorimeter, the gross calorific value of a chemical fuel can be determined. Okay. Next, let us look at the observations and calculations of this experiment. These are the observations. First, we should measure the weight of a chemical fuel that I am going to take as m kg. We always express the weight in terms of kg because we have defined GCV as kilojoules per kg. Mass of the chemical fuel taken as mkg, and mass of water that we filled in copper calorimeter is taken as W1 kg, and water equivalent of calorimeter is W2 kg. This cannot be measured directly. This is indirectly we are measuring. This actually accounts for the heat absorbed by other parts of the calorimeter. This is constant for a given calorimeter. From calorimeter to calorimeter, this W2 varies. Okay, this has to be determined by burning benzoic acid because its calorific value is known. First, we have to find out W2 for any calorific value. Then after finding this water equivalent of calorimeter, then we have to use that calorimeter to burn and to find out the calorific value of any other fuels. Initial temperature of water is noted as T1 and the final temperature of water is noted as T2. The rise in temperature or increase in temperature of the chemical fuel is delta T, that is T2 minus T1 degree centigrade. Okay. Here, the heat liberated by mkg of chemical fuel, whatever mkg means, the weight that you are going to take, is heat in a closed vessel is definitely equal to heat absorbed by water and other parts of the calorimeter, that is W1 plus W2 kg of water in a calorimeter. Let us look at heat liberated by mkg of a chemical fuel in a closed vessel is equal to, we know that heat liberated by 1 kg of chemical fuel is in a closed vessel is GCV, because in a closed vessel the gas are not allowed to escape, they are condensed back. Hence, whatever the heat that you are generating in a closed vessel, if you burn 1 kg of the chemical fuel, that is equal to gross calorific value. If you burn mkg of chemical fuel, obviously it is m into GCV. Therefore, heat liberated by mkg of chemical fuel in a closed vessel is equal to m into GCV. Next, let us look at heat absorbed by 1 kg of water to rise. We know that to rise the temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree centigrade is specific heat of water. It is standard and it is known. This is a constant for the water. 4.187 kilojoules of heat is required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree centigrade. This is known. If this much of heat is required for to raise temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree centigrade, then what is the heat required for W1 plus W2 kg. So therefore, heat absorbed by W1 plus W2 kg of water to raise its temperature from T1 degree centigrade to T2 degree centigrade is equal to how much? This is equal to W1 plus W2 cross multiplication into T2 minus T1 into S. Now I am substituting equation 2 and 3 in equation 1. We get this formula. M into GCV. This is the heat liberated by 1 kg of chemical fuel, m kg of chemical fuel in a closed vessel is equal to heat absorbed by W1 plus W2 kg of water and other parts of the calorimeter. I want GCV value. So therefore GCV is equal to this divided by m. Okay, this is the formula used to determine gross calorific value of a chemical fuel. And we can also determine NCV if you know the percentage of hydrogen. NCV we have already discussed is equal to GCV minus heat associated with steam. Heat associated with steam that we have already discussed, that is 0.09 into percentage of hydrogen into 587 into 4.2 kilojoules per kg. If you substitute that, you can also find out NCV if you know the percentage of hydrogen. Sometimes if sulfur or nitrogen is there, it liberates sulfuric acid and nitric acid, they are exothermic, then heat is not only liberated by the chemical fuel, that some amount of heat can also be generated by the formation of acids. So that heat has to be subtracted. Therefore, we have to make some corrections after calculations. We have to subtract A from whatever the heat we are getting. Similarly, magnesium fuse wire we are using inside the bomb calorimeter, it becomes magnesium oxide, that is also exothermic reaction, that also liberates some amount of heat, that also, that amount of heat has to be subtracted. I am going to take that as F fuse wire correction. And while cooling, there will be some error in each calorimeter, that is called cooling correction, that has to be added to the rising temperature. So therefore, after corrections, the GCV formula becomes W1 plus W2. To the rise in temperature, we are adding the cooling correction. The same formula, we are adding T2 minus T1 plus TC into specific heat of water minus we subtract the heat that is liberated by the acids formation and the heat liberated by the oxidation of magnesium. Okay. This has to be added. So generally, if they ask any, if they give any corrections, acid correction, fuse wire correction, and cooling correction, we have to use this formula, or else we can use directly this formula, GCV formula. As I told you, the W2 of a calorimeter, W2 of a is the water equivalent of calorimeter, is a constant for a given calorimeter. It has to be calibrated or determined by burning the fuel of known calorific value. For that, we use benzoic acid. Benzoic acid GCV is known, 26,434 kilojoules per kg. And we use the same formula, W2. This is the W2. I have rearranged that formula. This is GCV is known. If you take known quantity of benzoic acid, just measure the rise in temperature. S is known. Okay, this is the weight of water. Okay, this form, by using this formula, first we find out W2 for the given bomb calorimeter. Later, we determine the calorific value of other fuels. Just look at these pictures. So this is the stainless steel bomb, and this is having the way the air we place the crucible which contains the weight sample. This is the inlet for oxygen, which can here this electrically operated magnetic stirrer. We put this inside and we close it and put it in the copper calorimeter. Okay. So this is the benzoic acid that we use for this heat of combustion, standardized for bomb calorimeter, standard benzoic acid for bomb calorimeter. Okay. This is to determine W2 of a given bomb calorimeter. Okay. I hope this video is useful. I hope this video is useful, and if it is useful, please like it, comment it, and please share it and subscribe. And subscribe. Thank you. Thank you very much.